your ways. You are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect in all your ways, Jesus. You are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect in all your ways, Jesus.
You are perfect in all your ways, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are perfect in all your ways. Child of God, I see you. You are about to face temptation. God says the temptation is close, but do not worry. Only be careful and pray to God, because God has already proclaimed victory. It is not God that is tempting you. God does not tempt us. But God says, I should tell you that temptation will come. But trust in God. Have faith in God that you will defeat the temptations. From tomorrow, you will begin to see the temptation. Already you are feeling it, because signs of the temptation are already coming. But God says, I should tell you to be courageous. Fear not, for I am with you, says the Lord. You will conquer all temptations. No matter how the temptation comes, you will conquer, says the Lord. James chapter 1, 13 to 15, when you have it, say amen. When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desire and enticed. Then, after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, gives birth to death. When you are tempted, do not allow the temptation to overpower you. You must be tempted as a married man, as a married woman, as a young lady, as a young man, as a parent, as a reverend father, as a bishop, as a pastor, as a general overseer, as a choir mistress or choir master, you must be tempted in one way or the other. As a boss in the office, as a leader, as a teacher, as a doctor, as a preacher, as a nurse, you must be tempted. But when you are tempted, always have faith in God. There are ways that the world tempts us, depending on our faith of profession. Medical doctors receive their own temptation when they bring patients. They don't want to even touch the patients unless a particular deposit is made. And if the people are not able to meet up with the deposit, they leave the patient sometimes, and the patient may die. This is temptation, because if you have the power and ability to help, to save the life, and you didn't, and the person dies, your language is, oh, sorry, we lost him or we lost her. God writes it down for you and your generation. So you must be careful what you do, or when they bribe you to do some things that you are not supposed to do. You forget the Hippocratic oath you took to save life first. And then you focus on money, and you do some other silly things that are not good as a medical doctor. Then you fell into the temptation, and the final result or consequence is death. Not just physical death, but everlasting death. As a lawyer, you are tempted when you see that this is not right, this is not justice, but they bring the case because the big man has money. You judge the case against this poor orphan and widow, and take away their land, their inheritance, because you have received money, or you have seen that this person really won the election, But because you have been bribed, you have been promised for a better position, maybe you are just a lawyer, they say they are going to make you chief judge. And then you sell your position. You forget the oath you took to always keep to equity and justice. And God writes it down for you. And the consequences and the final result is death, everlasting death. You are a nurse. They come and bribe you. You go and you exchange the someone needs a male child, and then someone gave birth to twins. You said this one is late, blah, blah. Then you change it and you sell the baby. A lot of things happen in the world, really. God writes it down for you, and the consequences and final result is death, everlasting death. You are a teacher, a lecturer in the university. This young girl passed the exam, but because she has refused to give you her body, you fail her. Or because he has refused to pay money, you fail him when you know that he passed his exams. Then you say he is stubborn, he is rude, he is arrogant. You fail him. God writes it down for you. And the final consequences or result is everlasting death, eternal death in hellfire. Hallelujah. You are a pastor. And when that young woman comes to you for counseling, you begin to counsel off point. And before you know it, you end up in bed with her. The final consequences is death, eternal damnation. You are a woman because things are difficult for your husband now. You have turned into the iron lady of the house, and nobody can have rest again because you have become the breadwinner of the family. And when you go out, you come back by 12 o'clock. And when the man speaks, you say that I have a meeting. I have to put food in the table. Go out there and do something. And you begin to cheat with co-workers. And you think that you are growing. The final consequences and the final result is death. Everlasting death. Because no sin will go unpunished. You are a man. Because you are rich, you are handsome, you are cute. Guests flirt with you all over the place, at workplace, in the church, and then you don't know that your body is for your woman. You don't respect yourself anymore. You want to test everything in the skirt around you. And when you have tested them, when they see your woman, they don't have respect for madame. And madame will be posing as if she is all and all, without knowing that you have tested almost everything in skirt around her. Shame on you. It is hallmark of irresponsibility and scandalous. And the final consequences is death, or the result is everlasting death. Because no sin will go unpunished. Your body is for your woman. You must keep yourself for each other. You are not expected to sleep around, sleep here, sleep here. You are not. Even if you are rich, you are cute, or you are beautiful, you are rich, you have to keep that union. Sometimes I wonder how men feel when they have their woman in the house and they go out there and they go to open their body to another girl they meet in the street, or they know in the church, or they know in the workplace. They go to open their body and the girl will see their nakedness. For me, it's somehow shameful. I can't even imagine it, because to be honest, I can't do it. I am not a saint, but I am telling you this, I can't not do. Because it's somehow if you really have what it means to be a man, and you have a woman in the house, your woman, you will feel somehow, you will not even wake up. You will feel somehow, or you are a woman, you are married, you have your man in the house, you go out there, and then you are removing your clothes for another man somewhere in the bed. I don't know how you feel, how you get erection. This is, for me, somehow unimaginable, because I can't even imagine it. And then you remove all your clothes, remove everything for a strange person that is not your man. Oh, it's irritating, you know. And that is why Christ said that only on this should the man divorce the wife. Not only the wife divorcing, the man divorcing the wife. Oh, the wife also is a pari passu. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So temptations come our ways, but by the power of God Almighty, we have been given the power to overcome temptations. If you don't want something to catch fire, you know that there is petrol or kerosene in this object. You don't need to take matches. Cham, you are testing it. Cham, you are testing it. No, don't test it at all. Before you fall, there must be a sign. As a married man, a woman will not just come and begin to flirt on you. Before you fall, the person must have been giving you a sign. As a woman also, before something happens, the person has been giving you a sign. And it's because you are accepting the signs one after the other. That is why it has to get to that extent. If you cut it off from the beginning, it cannot. Because you have your will, you have yourself. Which emotion is going to overcome you? That you see yourself on another man's bed or another woman's bed. No. If you do not know how to control your sexual feelings, how can you claim that you are loving God? Hallelujah. Temptations will always come our way, but by the power of God, we have the ability to always defeat. God gave us the power to always defeat. We know that the law is good if one uses it properly. We also know that the law is meant not for the righteous, but for lawbreakers and rebels, the ungodly and sinful, the unholy and irreligious, for those who kill their fathers or mothers, for murderers, for the sexual immoral, for those practicing homosexuality, for slave traders and liars and perjurers, and for whatever else is contrary to the sound doctrine that confronts to the gospel concerning the glory of the blessed God, which he entrusted to me. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 8 to 11. Mark 10:6-9. But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Truth is the Bible itself. Everything that goes against it will be considered evil in the eyes of God, our Creator. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 8. And likewise, also, the men leaving the natural use of the woman, bond in their laws, one towards another. Men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meet, and even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. Romans chapter 1, 27, 28. Do you know that your bodies are members of Christ himself. Shall I then take the members of Christ and unite them with a prostitute? Never, says the Bible. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 15 to 16. So we must always be careful when tempted. Temptation must come. But as children of God, we are called upon to always withstand temptations. There are many ways we face temptations. But when we are tempted, let us always pray to God to give us the power and the courage to stand temptations. I can see you, child of God. Someone is coming to borrow money from you. He has perfected the plan to borrow the money from you. And the way he will come, you will want to give him the money. The money is huge. But the Lord God says, I should tell you, don't give him such amount. Give him a bit and tell him to work with that when the business he spoke about is going on, you will add. And then you will see what is going to happen with the bid. Then you will know what should have happened if you had given the much he is asking. He is asking you about 11 million. He is asking you about 11 million naira equivalents. In dollars, you are in United States. God says, give, but don't give as much. He said he is entering into transport business. Provide one for him. Let him start with one. You want to enter into transport business with a 5 buses at a time at a 2 million. And 1 million is for maintenance. 10 million, and he has sent documents and how it will go. That was not his plan. Give him 2 million for one bus and 200,000 for maintenance for one, since it is 11 million for the 5. Let him begin with the one, and after 2-3 months, you will see what God has revealed. All that glitters are not good. We are called to always help and to be generous, but we are not called to throw away our hard-earned money at the altar of help. That is why when you are helping people build, you help them build from the scratch. Not just throwing, and tomorrow you will begin to cry. I gave him 11 million and he never used it well. I will not give again. Give 2.2 million for one boss and let him control it himself. Control it, and learn the ways, learn the road, learn everything. Then you can give more. But I can assure you, you will see what the Lord have saved. Hallelujah, child of God. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. When temptations come, may we stand with God, and God Almighty will always deliver us and help us to come out of temptations in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, wonderful people of God, for participating in this ministration section. Today is the third day. 3rd of July, the 7th month in the year of our Lord Jesus Christ, Elohim, King of Kings, 2022. May the Lord God, who has sustained you through the past 6 months, sustain you the remaining 6 months by the power of the Holy Spirit. May God continue to guide you and to protect you. May he continue to be with you. May he continue to shower love upon you and your households by the power of the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever you place your hands upon from henceforth, we spring forth progress and prosperity, success. May you be blessed, child of God. May God help you. May God heal every sicknesses in your lives by the power of the Holy Spirit. May God wipe away your tears when you are tempted. Remember, you have a God who has vowed to be with you till the end of the day, till the end of the moon, till the end of the year, till the end of the universe. A covenant-keeping God who keeps his covenant everlastingly from generations to generations. May God bless you, child of God. I remain your humble servant, apostle, prophet, high altar of restoration, get ministry, Stockholm, Sweden, headquarters, saying shalom. Shalom. Peace, 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 peace.